We have always thought that it might be a good question to put to Mr. Kenneth Dodd and the members of the Beatles. To what extent do they attribute their success to their hairstyles? And we'll start by asking that question now of Mr. Ken Dodd.
With the hairstyle, well, I think it has a great deal to do with my, success.
Your hairstyle.
Oh, yes. Well, I think so, yes. I like to keep it in trim. You know, I eat a lot of shredded wheat because it's good for the hair. And I have it cut twice a year, whether I need it or not, short back and sides and a bit off the shoulders. And, you know, I think so.
Well, what do you feel about the boys?
I think there's a wonderful style, actually, because they're different than me. Of course, with them being Martians, they... A professor of archaeology at Nottingham University discovered some tablets which say that the Beatles are definitely Martians. Grundy's their leader.
How long have you known this, Kenny?
Bill Grundy? Well, I've known he was out of this world for a long time. all Martians. And as Martians, I think it's a very good hairstyle, lad. Very much. I'd like one of those myself.
Do you think that their hairstyles are the things that caught on, Ken? Do you think that's why they're so successful?
Oh, no. I think these boys have a very nice gimmick, talent. I think they would have gone with or without hairstyles. Who actually designed it, boys? Is it Camel?
Israeli.
Israeli? Oh, yeah. I thought it was done by Camel Lerds, you know. I have mine done there. You know, they get the scaffolding up once a year and...
All right, well, let's turn the tables out. Boys, what do you think of Mr. Ken Dodd?
That's great.
He's marvellous.
He's a good man. Lovely hair.
He's lovely hair. Hair is lovely.
Yeah.
We call it hair in Liverpool, you see. We always say the Judy with the fur hair. a fellow went into one of those shops once in Liverpool where they sell those, minks and things, and he says to the girl, he said, give us one of those hairy coats. I say, I beg your pardon, sir, what fur? He said, fur the Judy, who do you think?
Do you think that he owes a lot of his success to his hairstyle, fellas?
No, I don't think it helped at all.
It probably would have been better if it was bald.
Yeah. Bald? Oh, no. No bald. With the teeth, I think the teeth and the hair, all the gimmicks, you know, I think you have to have one. I think you definitely have to have a gimmick.
Oh, about the nose?
You've all got gimmicks, haven't you, Lloyd? Eh? What about the nose, yeah? What about the nose? He's a Martian. Actually, we were writing this film script for the boys. You know, the boys are making this new film, and we've been writing the script. And actually, we've cast Ringo in the part of King Charles on account of the thing, you know. And he goes along to Nell Gwynn and pinches her jaffers. And...
Tell us more about this picture. We didn't know about this.
Oh, yes, we've written the thing.
Oh,
all different parts. I'm writing
the script.
I'm writing the script, yes.
New deal.
Yes. with Nottingham University, you know, the help of the people, the professors there. He's King Charles. John is a courtier, and in this film, he wears a long golden wig with all beautiful curls.
Very nice.
And a blue velvet jacket. And like sort of knickerbockers with lace around the bottom, and buckle shoes with diamante clips on. And he's sort of walking around on the film set, and there's a policeman standing at the side, and he said, we'll pinch him when he comes off.
And what's he supposed to be doing, though? I mean,
well, John, he's a peasant. He's an evil son. Thingy, he's... he's an evil... an evil-smelling peasant.
An evil-smelling peasant.
Why is he an evil-smelling...
Why is he an evil-smelling peasant?
Comes down where I am.
You're finished.
Paul is a jester, you see, and he's always making the king laugh. Yeah. Every time he stands in his head, the king laughs like anything. He wears a kilt.
Is he pigeon chest?
The film all takes part, all about this. We're trying to get Brigitte Bardot to play Nell Gwynn, and he cops them one by one. And has them all, has their noggins cut off. At their head. And, and then they do, they've got this hit song which, what is it, what's the song? Please let me break your leg. Twist your arm.
Next week.
It's very nice too, lads.
This is, in fact, a period musical then, is that right?
Yes, all the boys sing. And of course, in the at the end of the film, this handsome Arabian prince comes on and finally steals Nell Gwynn. That's me, of course.
So you come on just in the last reel?
As an Arabian prince, yes.
As an Arabian prince?
Yes. Skavinsky, Skavar.
Imagine that's not... that's not very easy for you to come on as an Arabian prince.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. What, smoking me hookah? Oh, yeah, very well, that's... But actually, boys, that's nothing about haircuts, is it? I mean, you do have to eat any special food to keep this going. You have jam butties or...
No,
straw. You have? Oh, I
do.
I have the berries off the scouse bushes that grow on the banks of the Mersey. You have these and it's made into a juice. It's made, they get the, when the scouse bushes are in bloom around about the back end of November now, they get the berries and they squeeze them into a glass and it makes a wonderful juice called yaki juice. And I drink a lot of this yaki juice.
Yes.
And, you know.
There you go.
That's why I look like I do now.
Yeah. What about their guitar playing, Ken?
Wonderful.
Have you any comments to make about that?
Wonderful, because one of the boys is a big fan of Segovia. Oh. Yes, she's no mug, I mean, you know. Yeah. I like it.
Is this true, Segovia?
Segovia. Yeah. You're the big fan of Segovia, aren't you?
Yeah.
Didn't you ask for his autograph the other week? Well, I got it for you.
Oh, I read about that, yeah. Mm-hmm. I asked for his autograph. I didn't really, but I don't mind having it.
No, well, I've got a list of expenses down to the taxi, including Bob, from Notty Ash to the Philharmonic. And, I'll let you have it afterwards.
What about guitar yourself, Ken? Do you play? You don't?
No. I give a little tootle on the saxophone. You know, that's a ill wind that nobody blows good. And, just to annoy the neighbours.
But you no ambitions to play guitar like these lads?
Oh, I'd love to be able to play guitar like these lads, yes. I wonder if do you think you'd take a fifth Beatle on?
Yeah, well,
we were thinking of that.
Or, I mean, I don't want to split your group up, lads. I've often wondered, though, why you don't let Ringo sing.
well, why don't you let Ringo sing?
We could have a... I don't know, I don't know.
He does sing.
We do, you just haven't got the
new LP.
Yeah,
the
LP, no. Yeah, well, this is the new LP,
yeah,
which is up to number 17 or something right away in the top 40. Did you hear about that, Ken?
Yeah, really
the
wonderful.
New LP
wonderful,
is up.
Wonderful. I have an LP, a large pimple.
Bet you've had that one for a long time.
It actually is one of LP. It plays for 3 days. And there's a hole in the middle. You can either play it or blow peas.
Getting back to this group, Ken, have you no ambitions to form a group yourself?
Love to, with the boys.
Yes.
Kenny and the Cockroaches.
No, I mean, Kenny and the
Cockroaches. Or Doddy and the Diddy Man.
Yeah, what about yourself? Would you
Ringo and the Layabouts.
Would you not form one yourself, Ken?
Yes, I'd like to, yes, because the only thing is I'd have to change my name, you see. I'd have to have a name like Cliff or Rock, something earthy.
Well,
I don't know, eh?
Slash. Cliff Dodd.
No.
Rock Dodd.
No, let's invite suggestions for an earthy name for me.
Yeah, well, what about that fellow?
Sod.
Follow that. Gritty.
Well, it's
earthy,
anyway.
Gritty Dodd and his group.
Any more suggestions now, ladies and gentlemen?
I don't even follow that. But I'll leave that one alone. What about the boys? I mean, you asked me would I like to be a group. What about the lads? You're all...
I'd like to be a group, too.
You are a group. No, wouldn't you like to... You do comedy as well, don't you? I've seen John, you do some...
I just say lines.
Yes, you say some very good lines.
Oh, thank you.
That one, the